Hello, beautiful people. My name is Bridget, and welcome back to my channel. Hope you're all having an awesome day. And today, we're gonna do an unboxing. I love doing unboxings because I love a mystery. I like to just get goodies and figure out what they are. So that's what we're doing today. I also did just post on Monday on Halloween a hair color video where I dyed my hair gray on this side, and I put in a couple extra I kind of coated the pieces that didn't really get the coating before. So here's what it's looking like currently. It looks a whole haggard mess. It looks very purple to me on camera, which I didn't want, but that's what I'm working with. I'm not gonna do any extra layers of this hair color. I'm just gonna let it wash out since it is semi-permanent. But yeah, so that's the hair update. But let's get started talking about what we're unboxing today. Today we're unboxing the Ipsy Glam Bag X. Now this is every quarter of the year, so it's 4 year, $58. With over a $300 value, retail apparently, but $58 is so much money. So I need to know if these things are worth it today for, you know, this quarter. And let's see if it's any good for November 2022, almost 2023. Okay, but let's get started. Also, if you guys are interested in anything spooky or sweet, I do have some 6 feet under earrings available in my small business, as well as a whole bunch of other things. And after Halloween sale is going on now, we're adding a whole bunch of things to my sales section. And then also a lot of things that are already on sale are going to be discounted even more, so we can move them out of my, you know, inventory space. So yeah, there's that. If you want to check out theopencrypt.com link, theopencrypt.com link down below. And let's get started with this unboxing and see what's in here for $58. All right, so diving into the box now, I haven't taken a sneak peek or anything yet. Here is what's inside of the box. Let's move this fabric thing out the way. It's kind of hard to see what everything is in there. The box has a little bit of weight to it, but it's not the heaviest box we've ever gotten. But let's get started and talk about everything. So the first thing we have is the bag. Ipsy always does the bags, and I always try to think of a thing, like a use for the bags. And then when I get on camera, I forget what I was thinking. So this bag is like a velvet, has a little Ipsy tabs on it. It's a two zipper, which is a little different for them. They have this section and then they have this section. A use for this bag would be your toiletries and medicine. Yay! I don't know. If you're going somewhere and you need to pack those things separately. It's nice and cute though. I like the velvety fabric on this, and the color's really lovely as well. Very berry toned. And here is what's in the rest of the box. Let's start with this gold bar looking thing up top because it's blocking a lot of my view from the other things. So this is from Skin Ink Supplement Bar. It is a sculpt lift bar in 24 karat gold. I see people using these things. They also use like jade stones and stuff, and they rubbed them on their face, and it says it stimulates skin cell growth and everything. I don't know personally if that works or not. You guys let me know if you've had any experience with those things down below. I'm not a skincare guru, but this is the thing. It has a little white bag you can put it into. But I will also, since I don't think there's a card in here that tells me the retail price of these things, I'll put it on the screen for you when the items come up. It just looks like a flat little paddle that you rub on your face. And I'm not going to rub my makeup off my face right now, but this is the first thing in here. And because it says 24 karat gold on it, I know this is going to be a pricey item. This is going to take a lot of value, and it would probably fit in that bag just fine as well. So next up, I think I know what this is. So this is from Treloose Beauty. It's called the I Am Palette. I feel like I talked about this on Unfiltered Opinions when it first came out. I think it's an influencer's makeup brand. I think it's called Treloose. If I pronounced it wrong, I apologize. But let's see if I can get it open, first of all. Okay, let's see what the colors look like. The inside of the box has this cardboard lining of yellow, and then this, I have seen this image before. Okay, I don't know who this girl is. Apologies, unless it says it up here. It doesn't, but here is the packaging. It's beautiful, beautiful, beautiful packaging on this. And then, the inside's fun. Okay, so cover again just because it's stunning. And then here is the color scheme. It has like neutrals, right? It has neutrals, everyday wear. It has some orange and bright yellow, greens, blues, pinks, everything. Oh, it's so nice. I love these oranges. These orange shades are really pretty. The yellow is really popping for me. And then also this red shade. Looks like it'd be like a really poppin'. I think if you blend it, I'd be more orange than red. But it looks really pretty. I don't know if the blue, the one blue, and the two green shimmers really make sense in here. I guess technically this is probably a blue, but in the like on this where it's not facing the light, it looks green. Very green. So not really sure about the blue in here, but it's cute. I'm sure it's worth some money. It's a really interesting color story. It's like different. I like that. And I also like the fact that we have a white shimmer and a black matte. Those are really pretty. So gorgeous palette. And I'm interested to see what the retail value of this is because it looks really pretty. All right, next up is something from Anastasia Beverly Hills. Oh no, again. Okay. So this is Anastasia Beverly Hills' loose setting powder. Now their loose setting powder is really good. Vanilla is like it's my setting powder day actually. It's a beautiful setting powder. The white though, this is translucent, which is just a white. For drag makeup, it may be fantastic. But for my everyday wear, I find this white translucent setting powder to look so freaking dry on my face. It's like, it's really dry. So here it is. I think I have one that I bought for myself thinking I could do it for my under eyes and I didn't like how it looked on my skin. And then I think I have one that I got from TJ Maxx because it was on sale for like $14. I couldn't find vanilla, but it's a really dry setting powder. If you guys get a different color though, if you get vanilla, ooh, it's so fluffy, soft, and beautiful. It doesn't make your eyes look as bad as this one does. I don't know why it is that certain color looks better, but maybe the tint makes it softer. I'm not really sure. But this is the next thing in here. It has a good retail value on this as well. So if it was a different color, I'd be like ecstatic right now. Let's see what's next up. This looks like a hair thing. So this is the SOS Save Our Skin Daily Rescue Facial Spray. Okay, so it's a face spray. It says, yeah, I'm not even going to, is it Tower 28? Does this say Tower 28? Because that W thing is looking weird. It says spray protector. So happy solution to angry skin, soothe, purify, and renew. The SOS helps seriously soothe stressed out skin. Our hero ingredient, hypochlorous acid, maximizes your good skin days by reducing the appearance of redness and supporting skin's renewal process for all skin types, including sensitive skin. So this is the spray. Feels a little gimmicky. Don't know why I feel like it is a little gimmicky, but soothing is actually a thing. So if this was like a soothing setting spray or primer mist, I think maybe I'd like it more than just like a regular mist. However, if I was gonna use something to soothe my skin, I would use this not to get my hands dirty because I don't like put my hands in all kinds of gunk because I feel like bacteria is in my gunk in the container. I don't know. Anyways, let's move on to the next thing. This next thing is from Josie Moran. It's an Argan Pro Retinol Eye Cream to soothe and hydrate. There's a lot of soothing going on in this box. So it's just a little eye cream box. I want to say that I use eye cream. I forget. Once in a while, I'll use a caffeine eye cream from Good Molecules underneath my eyes in the mornings. If I'm not going to wear a skin and I'm leaving the house really early in the morning. But most of the time, I don't use eye creams. I should, right? I should. But whenever I'm doing my skincare routine, I just think of what I'm doing afterwards. I don't think of like, oh, let's enjoy the skincare routine. I don't know why I should, right? But this is the eye cream from Josie Moran. And then here is what it looks like on the inside. It's just a little thick cream. It doesn't have any fragrance, which I think is probably good for your sensitive under eye skin. Oh my gosh, I was talking to someone I think it was last week or the week before, that I had gifted some skincare products to that I wasn't going to use, right? Because who can use all the skincare in the world? And they said that their skin hurt under their eyes and it was peely. And I was like, oh, what did you use? Did you moisturize? And they said they exfoliated their under eyes. And I was like, chemical toner, like a liquid you rub on to tone or exfoliate? And they said, no, they scrubbed the under eye skin. And I was like, oh my God, it's so bad, they can't do that. I'm not a skincare guru, but I know your under eye skin is sensitive, so I would never try to like exfoliate that. Hope they learned something from that one. Oh, at the bottom of the paper, we have a little newspaper. I forgot we get these. So this is the Glam Bag X curated by Becky G. I think she might be the influencer that has this palette. So here is the new newspaper. I don't know who Becky G is, but she looks pretty. Her eyebrows are amazing. Wow. Okay. So it says Born for the Spotlight. And then here it gives you like a little... Oh, I could tell you the retail prices without having to search on Google forever. Okay, let's talk about the prices. The Tre Loose Beauty Eyeshadow Palette, $30. Honestly, $30, if this is good quality, is a deal because this is a really unique color story and the palette packaging is beautiful. For this mist, oh Lord, I don't see the mist. Okay, the mist is not in here. So I have to look up the mist for you. Let's see, what else did I unbox? I did the eye cream. We just did the eye cream. I don't know what that is either. Apparently, I do not have the same stuff that's in here. So I don't know how much the eye cream is. I thought this was going to be helpful. The setting powder is also not in here. Oh, okay, here's the eye. Okay, I found the eye. This thing, $76. Wow. This one says it's from, So I got the wrong eye cream. This eye cream, it says it's from Byro. This is not from Byro, but the Gold Lift Skin Bar retails for $125 for a little piece of metal that rubs your skin. People just charge outrageous things these days. And that's why they end up in subscription boxes, people. Who's paying $125 for that little thing to rub on your skin? That's insanity. Regardless, okay, let's talk about what's in the rest of the box. So we have this from Alginus. This is an algaronic acid and vegan collagen. It moisturizes and nourishes. Genius Collagen Nourishing Lip Balm. I do like a lip balm. I prefer like a regular, like a chapstick stick lip balm though. But this is from Alginus. Let's see if my little booklet tells me what the retail price of this is. It does. It says this retails for $29, which is an expensive lip balm, to be fair. So you get this box, and then here's the little container on the inside. I'll say the container's cute. And let's see what the actual lip balm looks like. It doesn't have a fragrance. It's just a clean lip balm in here. And yeah, the retail's for $29. So this thing is cute. We got two little boxes. I don't know why I unboxed them beside each other, but I did. And then it looks like we have two last things in here, and there's nothing under my styrofoam stuff because I always check. But this next thing is from Iconic London. This is the Brow Silk Kit. It contains one brow silk and one brow brush. So the Brow Silk Kit, used wet or dry, our brow silk creates naturally full, feathery brows with zero mess. Okay, sure. Some of us don't have that many brow hairs. Like, I don't pluck my brows anymore. I haven't in, gosh, it's probably been over a year now. I just don't even worry about it. So here's the first thing in here. It's a wax. Okay, we can call it the Brow Silk Kit all you want to. All you want to, but it's still, it's just brow wax. You get this big box. This is what comes out of it. All of this is filled with cardboard. So if you look in there, it's mostly cardboard and a brush. Like, this box is really big for this. Okay, so you get a little brow brush, you in your wax, and you go wah, 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 for feathery brows. I've never a day in my life tried the feathery brow trend because I feel like it looks, I don't know, caterpillarish if you have brow hairs. I just feel like I want my brows to be filled in. We've evolved past all the stages of the brow routines. We've done the light feathery. We did the stick thin, which is why I don't have many brow hairs now. We did the super blocked out Instagram brows. And I just determined I'm just gonna fill them in where they grow and deal with that. I can't anymore. Let's see if I got a price on these though. So the Iconic London Brow Silk Duo of the Wax and the Brush retail for $25. And we have one last thing in here. So this is the Lights Lacquer, which I know is Kathleen Light's nail polish company. Demi pot au tea. So we have two nail polishes in this little duo. I'm not sure what the colors are yet. I've never tried her nail polish. I'm not good at doing my nail polish. Okay, so the first color we have, ooh, it's a really pretty nude. Such a pretty nude color. This looks really pretty. So I like nail polish. You know, obviously I have a lot of nail polish actually. I really enjoy nail polish, but I keep my toes black because I don't feel like messing with them. They just stay black, just black toenail polish. And anytime I get a chip or something, I just fix that up and we're good to go. I don't like messing with it. And then nails, I like regular nail polish for my fingernails, except I feel like my nails aren't very pretty and my nails break a lot when I don't have anything on them. So, and also regular nail polish, I feel like regular nail polish, I feel like chips a lot. So I went to gel polish. And then after a while, I got an allergic reaction. Every time I touch gel nail polish and everything around my finger would feel like it's hurting and burning. And it was a very unpleasant experience. Although I did find that gel nail polish helped preserve my real fingernails from breaking because they have like a thick coating. And then I went to the press-ons and these were $5 at Walmart. They're like, they're salon perfect bewitched Halloween nails for $5. And I just keep ordering $5 press-on nails from Amazon and it works just fine. So that's my nail polish journey. The new color though, very beautiful. And let's see what the other color is. They look very similar. Okay, so here's the other color. It's a more nude. It's a more pale nude. So here are the two colors beside each other. It's a really cute duo. I really think these two colors go well together. I also think it's really genius as far as like packaging goes, that the boxes are the same. You see the name of it through the hole in the bottom. That's genius, so she doesn't have to order a whole bunch of different boxes. It's really smart business-wise. All right, so let's go over everything we got in the Ipsy Glam Bag X for $58. So we have a little nail polish duo from Lights Lacquer. Really pretty colors. We have a little brow wax and brush duo from Iconic London. We have an Allergenist lip balm, a eye cream from Josie Maran. We have a little skin protection mist, a Anastasia Beverly Hills translucent setting powder, a Sculpt Lift gold bar, a Trey Luce Beauty eyeshadow palette, as well as the bag. Akasha. Okay, sorry. Akasha has a cough. She has a lot of like sinus allergy stuff and she hasn't had her medicine yet today because she didn't eat her lunch. So anyways, that's what we got in the Ipsy Glam Bag Plus. I think it was a lot, but it was a lot of skincare. Like the setting powder and the eyeshadow palette are like the only makeup in here. Rest is skincare stuff. Some of it's kind of gimmicky, like the little spray or the little paddle for your face. I feel like I wish it was more makeup, truly. But I do feel like the things in here were high, like retail value. It wasn't just like e.l.f. or anything, so it was more expensive products. But anyways, let me know what you guys think down below. I'm gonna feed everybody more lunch because Akasha didn't eat hers and give her medicine. But thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you enjoyed it. I did. I like the mystery. I like finding out what things are in the boxes and stuff. So yeah, thank you guys so much and I will see you later. Have a great day. Bye. Why'd I pause for the bye? Why'd I pause?